Welcome to the Sunmark 360. On this episode, we're going to share tips to help you jumpstart your credit. Is there a limit to how much a person's income impacts their happiness? We're going to share the findings of a new study. And the Super Bowl is this Sunday, but just how much will it cost you to see the game in person? Well, let's just say the couch just might be the better choice.
From the Sunmark Credit Union Content Studio, this is the Sunmark 360 with Glen Stacey.
It's great to see you this week. I'm Glen Stacey. Welcome to the Sunmark 360. From your finances and family to optimizing your health and lifestyle, you can look right here to the Sunmark 360 for useful tips and tools to help you come full circle and manage it all. Sunmark is thrilled to support entrepreneurship and the dream to own and operate your own business. And now that the Capital Region Entrepreneur Bootcamp has begun, we turn our attention to student entrepreneurs and the Capital Region Business Plan Competition hosted by the University at Albany School of Business and presented by Sunmark on April 9th. During this competition, students, which include any graduate, undergraduate, or community college student enrolled part-time or full-time in an accredited New York college or university, will have the opportunity to present a business plan showcasing a new and innovative idea for a business product or service for cash prizes. The 2021 New York Business Plan Competition will feature regional competitions in New York's 10 regional economic development council zones. Those include the Capital Region, Central New York, North Country, Mohawk Valley, Finger Lakes, Western New York, Southern Tier, Mid-Hudson, New York City, and Long Island, and followed by a statewide competition. The winners will be selected by esteemed judges, including venture capitalists, angel investors, investment bankers, experienced entrepreneurs, and leaders from the business community. The 12th Annual Capital Region Business Plan Competition, presented by Sunmark, will be hosted by the University at Albany School of Business on April 9th. And students that are interested, there will be a Capital Region Business Plan Competition Zoom information session Friday, February 12th from 1 to 2 p.m. Since 2010, 2,800 teams and students from colleges and universities from across New York have pitched their ideas in the business plan competition. For more information, visit the news and events section at albany.edu/business. The Super Bowl is this Sunday, and the NFL is going to allow 22,000 fans at this year's game in Tampa, Florida. Want to go? Well, get ready to clean out your Sunmark account. Game Time, an app and site for last-minute tickets, has seats available for the Super Bowl, and ticket prices have been going up. Fans wanting the most expensive seats currently available on Game Time will be paying about $8.39 for each second of game action. So here's how much it will cost to go to the game. The cheapest to get in is $11,034 per ticket, and you must buy a four-pack. That's $3.07 per second of game action. The median to get in is $16,400, or $4.55 per second. And the most expensive to get in? $30,220 per ticket, and you must buy the four-pack. That's $8.39 per second of game time. Now, to put that amount into perspective, here are a few things the team here at the Sunmark 360 thought you could do with the money instead. How about a car payment? Toyota is an advertiser for the 2021 Super Bowl, so it seems fitting to point out that you can make a good-sized car payment for the price of a Super Bowl ticket. For the cheapest ticket, $11,034, you can make 15 payments of $735 each on a new 2021 Toyota Highlander Hybrid. That's assuming the price of $37,000. Up for a sweet deal? Another Super Bowl advertiser is M&M's, which got us thinking about our favorite candy. And to really satisfy our sweet tooth, you could buy 1,450 34-ounce bags of peanut butter M&M's at $8.98 per 34-ounce bag. Or, instead of going to Tampa, Florida for the Super Bowl, why not go to Orlando, Florida instead and visit the happiest place on earth? When we are COVID clear, you can buy 10 10-day tickets to Disney World for the cost of a Super Bowl ticket, meaning that you could hit all the parks several times. Are you ready to jumpstart your credit? Well, if you develop these two essential habits, you could be well on your way. Your credit score is the starting point for your journey toward building credit or restoring it after a setback. The next step is understanding how the way you handle your finances affects your credit score. Two things matter much more than any other: paying on time and how much of your credit limits you use. Paying on time matters most because paying on time is the single biggest factor in your credit score, and for credit scoring purposes, on time is within 30 days of the due date. It's virtually impossible to add points to your score if paying late is a habit. Worse, accounts at least 30 days past due can stay on your credit record for as long as 7 years. So how can you stay on top of your payments? Well, how about setting up automatic payments to cover at least the minimums due, assuming you reliably have enough in your bank account to avoid overdrafts. You can set up alerts to let you know a payment is coming up. If you have an account that's overdue, it's important to try to catch up because damage to your credit score gets worse as a payment goes from 30 to 60 to 90 or more days late. As a previous late payment fades into the past, the damage to your credit lessens. Credit card balances have a big effect. The balances on your credit cards affect your score almost as much as on-time payments. In general, the less of a credit card limit you use, the better for your score. In credit card speak, this is credit utilization, and it's expressed as a percentage. Most experts advise using no more than 30% of your credit limit, and less is better. Keeping your balances under that 30% suggests that your debt is not so high that it would be difficult to pay down. The good news, once you're able to whittle down your credit card balance, it will stop damaging your score. So how do you keep balances low? Credit card issuers report your balance about once a month. The amount reported most often matches the amount on your monthly statement. You can pay your balance before the statement is issued or pay online as often as you'd like. Regularly check your balance, or you may be able to set account alerts to be notified when your balance reaches a limit that you choose. What else to know? Well, if you usually pay on time and you use just a small part of your credit limits, you can expect to have a decent score. It really is that simple. Scores also consider other factors too, but taken together, they make up roughly one-third of your score, and they include credit diversity. Scores reward having a mix of credit cards and loans with a set term and equal payments, though it's possible to have a good score with just one type. How often you apply for credit. Several credit card applications close together can inflict temporary damage. And the length of credit history. Longer is better. Consider keeping credit cards open and using them lightly unless you have a compelling reason to close them. If you have questions about your credit score or need help setting up a plan to pay down debt, Sunmark is here to help you with your financial wellness. This includes a free credit review from Sunmark, which includes a free review of your credit report, as well as your score, but also the opportunity to discuss the details of your report with one of our knowledgeable staff. You can determine which loans or credit cards that could be consolidated into a lower rate loan, identify ways to pay down your debt, and we'll guide you on the right track to raise that credit score. This is a community service, and you do not need to be a Sunmark member to take advantage of this free service. If you'd like to get more information, stop by any Sunmark location or call us at 866-SUNMARK. The old saying goes, money can't buy happiness, but a new study finds that might not exactly be true. Although previous studies find there's a limit to how much a person's income impacts their happiness, a researcher from the University of Pennsylvania says the sky's the limit when it comes to money's influence on overall well-being. Matthew Killingsworth from Penn's Wharton School conducted a study that examined nearly 2 million data points from over 33,000 people, each providing a moment-to-moment snapshot of their daily lives. Other studies on income and happiness concluded that money stops mattering at around $75,000. The result of the new study, however, reveals that rising income continues to affect the earner's well-being, even into the hundreds of thousands of dollars. After calculating the well-being of each person in the study, Killingsworth compared the results to each participant's income. According to a 2010 paper, experienced well-being plateaus when someone hits $75,000 in annual salary. The new results find that number may have to change. In fact, the study reveals that each dollar a person makes matters the same to them, even as their salary reaches extremely high levels. Killingsworth found that one of the many links between money and increasing happiness is the flexibility a higher income gives people. Whether you're watching at home or in the office, thanks for spending a few minutes of your day right here with the Sunmark 360. For more, you can find our Sunmark 360 page at sunmark.org. Follow Sunmark on Facebook, YouTube, Instagram, Twitter, and LinkedIn. And we hope you contact the Sunmark 360 and let us know what you think about this episode at sunmark360@sunmark.org. We hope you have a great week, and we'll see you next time right here on the Sunmark 360. Don't forget to follow Sunmark and the Sunmark 360 on Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, LinkedIn, and YouTube.